So far, we have seen connecting to the data, connecting to the, see, we are, from the beginning, we are going to see the things in modules, module wise. First, we have seen the Remix IDE, where we have written the smart contract. We compiled the smart contract and we got the output. And we have also seen, after compiling the smart contract, we got some outputs, artifacts like ABI, bytecode, and other gas limit estimations, and all these things we have seen. And next, we have moved on to the creation of node in the Ethereum, then creation of a private network from scratch, and we have seen somewhat sophisticated way of doing, like a test RPC, where it will create automatically a private network and just will give you an URL, and you will take the URL into consideration, and we'll connect to the web. From web, we'll connect to the backend blockchain network. This we have seen. Now, why can't we have a complete integrated development environment? So for that, we'll see a IDE, integrated development environment, called Truffle. Truffle is a command-based integrated development environment. In order to work with Truffle, you must have a active internet connection, because the Truffle will generate the folders and will compile. All the things will be happened via online only, but the command will be executed or run from your computer. The rest of the operations will be done via online, that is via internet. The reason is, the smart contract may be developed using certain version of Solidity. We all know that we are supposed to write Pragma, Solidity, Solidity version. One may use 0.5.0 as the version, another may use 0.8 point something as the version. So whatever the different versions that you use, for that you cannot install a related Solidity compiler, or you may completely depending upon the Remix IDE also. The Remix IDE will give you certain part like compilation and testing of your contract by providing you some test accounts. Now, once it is done, it will give you an artifact like outputs like ABI code, mission and this bytecode, some these kind of things will be provided to you. Now, with that, we need to develop an application, and we should connect to the application. For that, again, we need to come back to the other platforms. So this is a tedious task. So for this, what can we do is, we may use a integrated development environment called Truffle, where we no need to worry about what type of Solidity version we are using, which libraries we are using. This automatically will be taken care by the Truffle itself. Only thing is, we need to call the Truffle commands, and the rest of the operations will be done from the internet. So it will identify what is the documentation, what is the library we are using, and automatically the related compilation will be happened. So all these things will be done via internet. So hence, we no need to take a lot of risk in doing this. And further, another one is, it will also give you facility, that is facility for all the dependent files by generating at the time of setting up of your project. That means while setting up the project, automatically it will generate all the related files. All the skeletons of all the related files will be generated, and skeleton code will be generated. Only thing is, we need to replace that, replace our contract names, smart contract names, in that skeleton code. So thereby, it will make the developer's task easy. So in this Truffle IDE, first one is, create a directory, initialize for various components of the dapp using truffle init. So truffle init is a command used for initializing, creating a directory. Whenever the truffle init was used, we already discussed that truffle require an active internet connection to work. So from the internet, it will generate the project folder. That project folder consisting of several subfolders like the contract folder, test folder, and some other dependent JSON files automatically generated by the truffle init. So creating a directory initialize for various components of the dapp using truffle init. Next, create the contract.sol file in the truffle ID, and the first step is truffle init. Once the truffle init command is called, then automatically the related folders will be generated. The second step is create the contracts, that is .sol file in the contracts directory, and compile using truffle compile. So here, whenever the init was called, automatically it will generate the folder such as contract folder and test folder, these kind of things. Now you may use the remix IDE or any other thing. You may type the Solidity code and compile it and run it and test the Solidity code, and that sol file should be placed in the contracts folder. And you may, from the command prompt, you may go for truffle compile. So automatically it will compile the contract file and will give you any error if the program is having. Anyhow, if you might have done the Solidity code on the remix IDE and you have tested, then you won't get any error. If any error is present, then automatically it will show you on the command prompt. Next, generate the test blockchain account using truffle develop. So the truffle develop will generate a test blockchain account using this truffle develop. Next one is, that means it will generate some, automatically a private network will be generated and with some test accounts. That means it will give you around 10 accounts, like how the remix ID will give you the test accounts with some toy ethers. Like that, this truffle will also generate some blockchain accounts using truffle develop. So truffle space develop will give you the blockchain accounts, test accounts. Next one is deploy the compiled contracts to test blockchain. So you may choose one test network of the Ethereum, either maybe RingB test network or maybe Kevin test network. You can choose according to your wish. So but by default it will go into the RingB test network or some test network of the Ethereum. We have already seen during the node creation and the private networks creation, there is a network ID. Some specific network IDs are there which are public in nature. They cannot be used for private blockchains. So on Ethereum, there exists several networks. So what the truffle will do is it will select one test network, one private network for testing your application. Once you have tested the application on the private network, and if you are satisfied that nothing will happen with my application, so anyhow, it is a, what are the accounts created are dummy accounts only for the testing purpose we use. In a live environment, we use that on the test network. After coming to a conclusion that you have developed the network perfectly and there is no problem with the network, then you may create your own private network and you may migrate it to your network and may run on your private blockchain. Or if you are planning this for the public network, then there is a facility in Ethereum networks to create your own public network and can launch onto the onto the public networks. So let it be, but this we are doing only for testing our development on our test networks. So for this we use the truffle. Truffle is the command, and along with this one you have to pass the parameter called migrate. So automatically the truffle it will deploy the compiled contracts to test the blockchain. Next one is that the beauty of the truffle is we may also write test cases for testing our blockchain. So add the test files for testing the functions of the contracts. So whenever we write the test functions, then we can go for truffle test, so that our contract will be tested against the test cases that we have prepared. If they are successful, it will return success. Otherwise, it will return fail, where that particular function was failed, for because of what reason the function was failed. These details that you have mentioned in the test case, that will be provided, that will be appeared onto the screen. That means this IDE will give you the first, from the directory creation to the testing of your application. So for this, the software is required to install are Node.js is required, Truffle version 4.0.4, or now the current version may be greater than this 4.0.4, and MetaMask framework or MetaMask plugin for the Chrome is required. Anyhow, these three were installed in our Bodhi Linux. So whenever we go for creating a folder to work the enter, we'll see a Ballot folder, Ballot smart contract. To create the Ballot smart contract or Ballot blockchain project, mkdir Ballot, you go to the Ballot folder, cd Ballot, and now you type truffle space init. So it will initialize the truffle space init will initialize this Ballot smart will initialize this project, and will generate the folders like this: contracts, migrations, test, truffle.js, truffle-config.js. These are the folders will be generated automatically whenever we go for the truffle init. In contracts folder, we place the Solidity file that we develop for the smart contract. Next, in the migrations, in the test folder, the test cases that you have developed to test the Solidity code will be placed. And in the migrations folder, we may write multiple contracts in the contract folder. In contract folder, we may have more than one file of type contracts. But which contract to be migrated onto the test network, that details must be provided in the migrations folder. In the migrations folder, there will be a default, some files will be there, migration files will be there. If you open that file, some template code will be there. In the template code, just you replace the template code, some template code will be there. That code should be replaced with the contract name that is supposed to be placed on the private network or test network. That need to be edited. After editing, we may use the command truffle migrate, so that whatever that contract that you have written in the migrations file, configuration file, that contract will be migrated and placed onto the blockchain on the test network. So like that, these are the three folders, and this is the general configuration of the truffle, truffle.js and truffle-config.js, which consisting of the configuration script, like what are the different contracts, what are the test files, what are the migration details. All these can be plugged to this truffle.js and truffle-config.js files. Wherever the there is a specific places will be there where we are going to go for the editing of the contract details and migration details, test details. And then finally, if you go for truffle migrate, then the entire code after a successful execution, the code, the entire network, entire contract will be migrated onto the test network. And as like how the test RPC will provide the URL, in the same way, this truffle migrate will also provide us a URL, and that URL will be used, and we develop the Web3 interfaces and communicate with the blockchain. So this is the way we use this particular truffle IDE.